It's now time to put the panelists on the clock. They'll have 1 minute as a group to respond to a variety of subjects. Let's get going. In the Democratic primary race for Congressional District 1, Bill Clinton endorsing Martin Chavez. Michelle Lujan Grisham just nabbed the endorsement of Diane Denish. And Laura, what do politicians, what do you think will come, you know, from these kind of endorsements? Where does that leave Eric Griego? Does he need to go out and get a high-profile endorsement at this point? Oh, and the guys from Breaking Bad, sorry, endorsed Martin Chavez as well.
Yeah.
I had not heard that.
Yes.
That's interesting. Well, I mean, this is certainly the time where people start to line up, you know, the big guns on their side and so forth. You know, this weekend coming up is the ward level elections for delegates. And then that leads into the delegate race for the county at the county level and then at the state level. And that determines ballot order. So I think right now is the time where people are trying to say, look who's on my side. What's interesting about the Marty Chavez one is, you know, Marty Chavez came out early for Hillary Clinton in 2008.
That's
so
right.
I'm not surprised by that connection. He was one of the solid, you know, Clinton delegates back then, so it's sort of a payback thing. The Denish thing,
and they jogged together when they
and they did.
He was president.
And Emily's List also endorsed Michelle Lujan Grisham. So.
Thank you for adding that in. As a matter of fact, does this mean more money for people? These kind of endorsements?
I think the Emily's List absolutely means more money. That's what it's about. Yeah. But I typically don't think endorsements mean all that much. But Bill Clinton is a biggie, and I do kind of think it might have made it a more three-way race than it was before. But I think it's definitely more exciting of the two right now.
Interesting.
Yeah, one has to question the value of a Bill Clinton endorsement. He did, especially in the West. He endorsed a candidate in this U.S. Senate race in Colorado. That candidate lost in the primary.
I'm going to hold you there. So if it's just absurd, that's a quote, says Winston Brooks, to a rumor that he was resigning from the APS job he has. Jamie, think this was a vindictive move by someone looking to cause trouble for the superintendent, possibly?
One has to wonder about, you know, a man that's consistently opposed Governor Martinez's education reforms and actively putting staff in Santa Fe that are fighting against social promotion and the other sorts of bills that are out there that have wide-ranging support.
Mm-hmm. What's in this? What's behind this thing between the governor and Mr. Brooks?
It's a good question. I think that there are very different philosophies going on there. But I also think that for someone like Winston Brooks, his time at APS has not exactly been smooth, and so it is not surprising that a rumor like this would come out, whether it's founded or not. It may be wishful thinking on some people's parts, but he's saying no, and I guess I believe him at this point.
Interesting. Politics, is there an upside for the governor here that I'm having trouble seeing?
I don't know if it's an upside, but whatever the governor's for, Winston Brooks is reflexively going to be against it, no matter what it is. You know, with social promotion, I think it was just giving schools the authority to hold the third graders back who they thought couldn't read. Why would a school not want, you know, the authority to be listened to? But governor says she's for it, he's against it, we don't want, you know, this authority.
So,
I wouldn't miss him.
Gonna hold you there, Laura. After the uproar over the Obama administration's recent ruling, a compromise plan was proposed to have insurance companies rather than religious organizations provide birth control coverage for workers. Some praise, some compromise, saying it creates the proper moral distance. I love that term. Others say the compromise is an accounting trick and violates religious freedom. So if you were strong on this last week, does this compromise work for you?
It works for me beautifully.
Okay.
And you know what? It works for a large number of Catholic organizations who are not the bishops themselves.
Right.
It's gotten tremendous support from Catholic health organizations, et cetera. I think what it perhaps does is it highlights the distance at this point between the Catholic bishops and their own parishioners.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. Let me come back. I left you out the last one. Follow up on what Sophie said. Does that seem plausible to you as well?
Well, I think at the very least it provides a little bit of that separation that part of the controversy was also the separation of church and state idea. So this, you know, requiring that the insurers gives a little bit of separation. I'm not sure if it's moral distance, but at least legal separation somewhat. But I suspect that the church probably will be unhappy by this, but there are a lot of others, Sophie said, a lot of other affiliated groups that may be breathing a sigh of relief.
Interesting. I'm going to hold you guys there because that's a good one right there. Next subject. We lost a great one in Whitney Houston recently. Everybody knows about this. Young, died young, amazingly talented. She burst on the scene in an amazing way, Jamie, in the 80s. It was really quite something. The loss, when you hear people talking about her, people particularly in the music business, and what this woman accomplished, it really brings home just how much power she had.
It does, and at the same time, it wasn't a surprise. My wife texted me while I was on a 4-hour plane back from Washington to Albuquerque. I turned on my phone, and it's just Whitney Houston died. and I wasn't surprised.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And I think that, but what I'm sad about right now, though, is that not enough attention has been placed on drug and alcohol abuse coming out of her death. Mm-hmm. There's been a little bit too much of, in my mind, of the talking about, you know, how the sentimentality about it,
sure.
her great performances and whatnot, which I admire, but
yeah.
we should be using this as a teachable moment.
And we should look at the whole picture of the woman's life, certainly. We have to include that bit in, but how does that fit in with the rest of her
arc? I think
as
well, just to build, I think that that one of the messages that comes across is that the music industry is still an enabler in some ways of self-destructive behaviors. Mm-hmm. And that we're going to continue to lose people, mm-hmm. potentially, if that isn't addressed.
Mm-hmm. But no one seems to hear that message, Colin, do they? It just happens over and over.
Yeah.
You know, I don't have much on this, but, it's not a big surprise. You know, I think it's an industry that, you know, will be able to find doctors, and it's mm-hmm. too bad.
Interesting, going to hold you there. Laura, finally, college sports contraction comes to New Mexico. As you heard about this, the Mountain West and the Conference USA joined together to create, I don't know what we call it, a super conference, perhaps, but a new athletic conference. Just last year, we thought UNM might join the Pac-10. Remember that? To settle things for you? I don't know if you're a college sports fan or not. But
I'm a huge college sports fan.
Are you?
Fan,
I didn't know that
not,
about
I'm
you.
Not a huge Mountain West conference fan. I'm sorry, I'm not. I was a Pac-10 girl. Mm-hmm. But I think this is very interesting. For me, it's so huge and unruly, you know, in many ways. We're talking about teams all over the in all four or five time zones, mm-hmm. And that I mean the logistics of it will be interesting to see how it plays out. It doesn't happen until the 2013-2014 I think
That's
year,
right. mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
they have some time to plan.
It's all about dough, TV money, all that kind of thing.
Yeah, I think it's a little bit about
yeah.
money, but I think money, you know, is because of interest. I think it's exciting because it's kind of a coast to coast national league. I think it'll be good for the Lobos. I think the Lobos are also kind of a source of pride for UNM, so mm-hmm. I'm excited about it.
That was going to be my question to you, Jamie. Is this good for the Lobos? Does this really elevate our profile somehow?
Your profile? I'm an Aggie. So I said this last time I was on the show. So,
I
don't have as much interest in this one, I guess.
That's good. Interesting. Sophie?
You know, I think this is an attempt to follow what happened with Pac-10 and mm-hmm. that the goal is to make some more money, to have TV in all four time zones, to really expand that. Whether this level of play, whether this level of team is going to be able to do that mm-hmm. is something we'll have to see.
Mm-hmm.
But I think it's a promising step.
And you have to win games.
Yeah.
I don't care what league you're in, you have to win games. We're out of time. Thanks, you all. Good to see you guys again.